We're talking about same-sex marriage with San Francisco Mayor Gavin Newsom, Reverend Jim Garlow, Bishop Harry Jackson Jr., and Dan Savage. Reverend Jackson, 70% of African Americans voted yes on Prop 8.
Yes.
Against gay marriage. What do you make of that?
Well, I think it shows that there's been a hijacking of the civil rights movement by the radical gay movement. If it was so obvious that these things are so similar, how come black people vote against it? And I think it has to do with the fact that marriage is an institution that is prized. The redefinition is a major problem. And also, I believe that there's a tantamount or there's a measure of racism in the gay movement. Jasmine Kanick of Los Angeles Times talked about this last week. She says, hey, this is a major problem, that there seems to be a dual standard between black gays and white gays. One of the things
How
that was written...
How is there racism? I don't understand it.
Well, what she's saying basically is that blacks are treated second class even within the gay movement.
Is that so, Dan?
I would disagree with that. I would also disagree with that there's been a hijacking of the civil rights movement by the gay rights movement. I respect the unique African-American experience on this continent over the last 400 years.
You can't put your sin with my skin.
The African-American civil rights movement will always be the civil rights movement, all caps, capital T, capital C, capital R, capital M. It is the civil rights movement. Ours is a civil rights movement. There are parallels between our civil rights movement and the African-American civil rights movement. But there is not an equation being drawn by gays and lesbians in this country. It's a very different experience.
You can't connect up the dots. Wayne Beeson wrote for the Huffington Post on November 7th that he felt if you educate blacks a little more, they'll come along, that it's because they're not that informed that they're not for this issue.
Well, that's one person's opinion.
Yeah. Well, yeah, but if it was so obvious, wouldn't more blacks get it? So I think there's a moral reason for this. There's a problem. We in the black community especially understand America's in moral free fall. And right now, why take one of the basic building blocks, pull it out of the foundation, and destabilize what may be a teetering social...
Taking people who are living in committed relationships, often with children, and bringing them into the marriage fold does not destabilize marriage.
Reverend Garlow, do you think that homosexuality is a choice?
I don't think there's any proof, any conclusive proof, that people are born. There's no DNA, there's no gene or something that's distinctly homosexual. But I don't want to let pass what Dan has just said a moment ago, which is completely false. The analogy between interracial marriage and this issue. In the case of interracial marriage, all it was done was affirm that marriage is one man, one woman. The reason we would support interracial people being able to marry is because it supports the definition, the fundamental definition of marriage. One man, one woman. There's a reason why cultures all over the world have affirmed this same thing. It's not even a Bible thing or a Christian thing to them. It's because it works. A man with a sperm, a woman with an egg, produce the child and is the best posture to raise and nurture and care for that child.
But marriage isn't about children necessarily. People can be married without having children. People can have children without being married. People who are infertile can be married.
All right. Is gay marriage a civil rights issue? That's our quick vote question tonight. Go to CNN.com/LarryKing and weigh in. More with our guests next. Okay, we're having fun now. Joy Behar back with you on Larry King Live, and we're talking about same-sex marriage. Mayor Newsom, let me talk to you, because there was a case in Sacramento this week. A theater director was forced to resign because he was from the Mormon Church, and he donated $1,000 to vote yes on Prop 8. He seemed to be forced to resign. Do you think that that's fair?
No, I don't. Frankly, I don't like, on both sides of this, there's been some extreme elements that have been not been plain fair. Look, I have members of my own family, Joy, that disagree with me on this. I'm very passionate about this. I believe in real equality. I believe in full equality. I don't believe in separate rights for some people, in separate rights or equal rights or more rights for another group of people. I have a fundamental difference of opinion with people. But we can disagree without being disagreeable. We don't need to threaten people's jobs. The Yes on 8 campaign was exposing donors during the campaign. Now the No on 8 folks are doing that after the campaign. Look, we need to agree to disagree, but now work to try to reconcile the fact that 18,000+ families have just been uprooted, their lives dramatically impacted. We took rights away.
Right,
the Constitution was amended. This is real life for people, and
what
I hope we don't forget that.
What happens to those couples that got married? You know,
well,
Ellen DeGeneres and Rosie O'Donnell, they all got married in California. Yeah. Are they not married anymore?
No, they are.
And
they absolutely are, and they will continue to be. But let me just say this. There are those proponents of Prop 8 that don't want those marriages to remain legal. So they're in question. And the idea that we would put people, human beings, in this position to have afforded legal rights and then to strip them away by a simple majority. It takes two-thirds in California to get a budget. It takes simple majority to take the Constitution and throw out its constitutional protections. Okay. Let's focus on that fundamental
fact. Do you think that was fair?
Well, I want to defend Mark Shaiman and Jeff Whitty and others who, it was a musical theater, and they produced the work of gay and lesbian artists who, when they heard that the head of this theater, who is running this theater and benefiting from their labors, had donated this money to Yes on Prop 8 and regarded them as second-class citizens and was benefiting from their labors, they said they weren't going to work with this theater anymore, which is their right. You know, one of the signs that gays and lesbians are carrying around at the demonstrations, there'll be massive demonstrations across the country tomorrow, says no more Mr. Nice Gay. We've kind of had it up to here with being told that our relationships are somehow an existential threat or an attack on the American family and that we're a danger to children. And no other minority group in the country is subject to this campaign of stripping us of our rights, mending constitutions like this. And
Joy,
we're
can
not
I jump
put
in
up
here?
With it anymore.
Yes, go ahead, jump in.
Well, first of all, the judges were asked to delay it till after the people voted. 11 attorneys general from 11 different states said, please wait till then. Four judges refused. They refused to do that. So the stripping of the rights, they knew all along that the people were going to be vote because it qualified before the judges even removed Prop 22 as part of the law in the state of California. Secondly, when we talk about the no more Mr. Nice Guy, we need to cover, I'm here on the ground in California where we're monitoring and tracking with 7,200 pastors where there are rocks being thrown through church windows, where white powdery substances showing up in different places, where several couples have been beaten, numbers of individuals have been beaten. We have a lot of defacing of cars,
Reverend,
tremendous amount of vandalism. This needs to stop.
Right.
This
You're
needs
right.
to stop.
Let me ask you, Reverend, how does a gay marriage hurt you as a heterosexual? I'm wondering, how does it hurt you?
I wish we had about an hour for me to answer, but to put it in a soundbite, every place we have historical models where same-sex marriage is validated by the government, whether we go to Europe or where we go even to the United States, we find a stripping away of the rights, parental rights of parents, number one. Number two, personal freedoms and religious freedoms all evaporate very quickly. If you want more time, I'll be glad to give you more time to walk through all the examples.
We don't have that much time. It's only an hour's show, Reverend. We'll be back in 60 seconds. Have a couple of minutes left. You know, I want to ask you, Dan, about the fact that the Mormons are getting a lot of heat. Do they deserve it? I understand that some gay groups want to boycott the entire state of Utah. Can you do that to the entire state? You know, Roseanne Barr is from Utah. You know, not everybody in Utah is against gay marriage.
Well, $4 out of $5 that were spent and the money raised to pass Prop 8 was funneled by the Mormon Church to California, a lot of out-of-state dollars, and people understand what we said. I don't think anybody should be attacking churches or attacking preachers. We're sitting here having a very polite conversation.
Right.
Certainly nobody who's responsible supports violence, but we've reached a point where the attacks in the gay community are emanating from religious institutions, and we have a right to protest, exercise our free speech rights outside those churches.
But do you think, Reverend, that when the church gets involved in politics, that they should lose their tax-exempt status?
No, the laws say that we can advocate for issues like marriage, but I want to talk about violence. Right now, there's intolerance among gays. It's not being covered on the news. People making all kind of signs on churches. Also, there are people that are speaking out and using the N-word with other blacks that are out. And this is talked about in many blogs. So I'm just concerned. There's intolerance in this movement that's not being shown up. I think, quite frankly, many of the news media, like this one, might be biased and not showing both sides.
Well, we're doing exactly that.
There's a lot of intolerance. A lot of intolerance is being unleashed.
Let us talk about it.
Champion an intolerant movement, and it's really reaped the whirlwind in this country when you attack a vulnerable minority group. We've seen it historically over and over again.
Well, using the N-word, I think, is the ultimate of intolerance.
Okay, I've got to go. You guys
were
fantastic. We'll wrap it up after this, okay?